but store up for yourself treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust consumes, and where thieves do not break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart will also be.
Well, I told you last week it would be a short sermon, and it is. However, I also changed my mind about what I wanted to focus on. So what was read just now, that where your treasure is, your heart is also, that is so true. And Steve and I guess we were thinking the same way. Steve, this morning you said about stewardship, it is the joyous giving of your time, talents, prayers, energy, finances, witness, all of those things. Stewardship is joyous giving. And I heard God talking to me about the Stewardship Sunday and joyous being, it's a joyous event. So then I thought about the scripture, and this is what I want to just bring some thoughts on today. The scripture where Jesus went to the wedding in Cana and turned water into wine. This church family, with all that you do, and what I've gotten to share with you since I have been with you, is that you all are participants in a divine party with God. And this Stewardship Sunday just echoes that you came forward and you showed your commitment, not only with your financial gifts, but with your time, talents, prayers, witness. You, all of you, in some way, contribute to the ministry of this church. And that makes all of us part of God's divine party. And at the wedding party where Jesus was, he did something at the celebration, something that a public miracle, where he took something ordinary and turned it into something extraordinary. And this is what this church is about, that God uses us, ordinary folk, and turns us, using our gifts and talents and time and presence and witness, turns us into extraordinary people, extraordinary disciples who go out and do ministry in the name of this church, in this community, and in the world. And I like that notion of Jesus is at a party, Jesus does something, takes something ordinary, turns it into something extraordinary, and so do we as we participate with God in ministry. God is always at work making something new out of us, out of our ordinariness. And I'm grateful that you all do so much. There's not too much ordinariness going on in this church because you all are extraordinary. And I'm glad that I get to witness that and participate in it and be part of it and then go home and tell Rick, my pastor husband, about it and others. We exist to be the body of Christ and to carry out God's purpose for our lives. And the testimonies that have been shared, the gifts that you have brought forward, and the attitude you had when you brought them forward, I could see the joy. I could see the commitment. All of us bear witness to the Holy Spirit working in and through this church to share the good news of God's love in the world. And I just want you to think, as I close, that we are part of the divine party that God throws. We are extraordinary people turned into extraordinary disciples out of our ordinariness. And I'm grateful to God for that. you are valuable and you are worthy and you are loved, no matter how ordinary or extraordinary you are. All of you have valuable gifts to bring, and you bring them, and for that I'm grateful. Amen.